Well, folks, this is all for now. I'm finished with my shelter. As you saw, I put on the roof today, so it is waterproof now, I hope. It's first time I make such a large area with that material, so there's a little bit fault, but I think it's okay. Now my shelter is finished, and I'm going to start a little bit of decoration. I have some plants that I will put outside the shelter, and inside, you saw, I made my little birch tree, and I don't know if you can see in the background there. No. Oh, but there is a little skull. Yeah. So, a little bit Viking-like. And I have to try my stove first before I use it when I sleep here. So, if the weather is fine tomorrow, I'll be back here and fire up the new stove for the first time. I'm looking very much forward to that. I have to find something that can lever it out, because my ground here is very uneven. It's a slope, so the stove has to be secured in an upright position. So I have to find out what I'm going to do there. But of course I'm going to solve that problem too. Now it's time for relaxing and enjoying, and it's so great and so nice. It's been a journey for almost 14 days, and I worked not every day, but approximately every second day I've been out here. Sometime I only made a small task, and other I made some great progress. So, and actually I was out here Saturday. I was beginning to lay the roof, but then it began to rain and so on. So the weather is not the best for outdoor project at the moment. I hope you enjoy my serious shelter builds, and I thank you for all the nice comments you are giving me, and I'm actually very grateful for all the friendly and kind suggestion you are giving me. So I'll read them all, and I'll get back to you in the comment section what I think about your suggestions. Now, well, I sit here for a while, relax, enjoy, and then I'm driving home again, and hopefully I'll be out here again tomorrow. It will be in the same video, so you won't notice that, but today is Monday, and tomorrow Tuesday, and then I think the weather forecast is okay for that. So, I hope. Well, and as you saw, I put some beer. You can't call it baptizing, because it's not a Christian, it's a North shelter, I will say. I will make it in the Viking style. So I think the tradition to put something, perhaps mjød, on your ship in the old Viking days, I don't know. But I thought it was a good idea to do this with my new shelter, and hope it will stay here for a very long time. Thank you for hanging on, and thank you for dropping by. see I put something below so to stabilize it. A concrete tile, I think it's called, and as you can see, the chimney is up. So, but I'm not sure about this. It actually had to be more stable. You can see here, the legs are very close to the edge, particularly here in the front. I have to think about it, as I have to customize it a little bit. But soon I'll have fire. Well, now is the big moment. I'm going to fire up this awesome stove for the first time. You can see here, this air vent is open, and so is this. And I'll just feed it with some larger piece of wood. Plenty of room. And I have these twigs and some birch bark. So. And of course, I'm going to have these kindlings in inside, and birch bark. So these, yeah. Let's see if I can light a match. See in here if there's any progress. Yes, and you can hear it. And I just want to show you, I don't know if you can see it, but it's just around freezing point, 1+ Celsius degrees, I think. So I'll see how hot it gets in here when the fire is going. And I've been told that I shall fire it up for at least 1 hour the first time. There can be a lot of oil on the surface of this stainless steel stove, so it has to be burned off, and I am not able to use it on the top before it's kind of seasoning. So but now we can see it's starting to evolve. And how about the smoke in the chimney? Let's see. Oh yeah. It's coming up nicely. That's great. Already very cozy to look at. I can feel the heat here, and if I look at this thermometer, it's 9 degrees Celsius after 15 minutes. So it's really nice, cozy in here, and warm. I think I'll turn down for the airflow. Yeah, I think. Yeah, and this knife from Worktough gear, it's a very nice knife. I used it during this project, my Kimber Camp shelter, and the steel is SK 85, I think it's 85, yeah. It's a very durable and a good knife to have in your hand, and it cuts like hell, sorry, but it's really sharp and I love it very much. The black blade especially, I love it, and the shape of the blade is also something that is cool. So I use this for all my cutting projects here in my building videos, and now I'm using it for a hanger for my rucksack. You saw I had a hook in the wall. I'll put this one up instead. I think it's more old school. Just have to refine it now. Yeah, very sharp. Worktough gear, the same company that makes Worktough stove. Really nice. And there you can see, I don't have my rucksack with me today, so I can't show you how it's going to be used, but I think you get the picture. And then I'll take this one out. It's not old school. Well, so I'm going to make more of these so I can put things on, my jacket and so on. I have to figure it out where I would have it, but a little small project.
Yeah.
So now it has burned for an hour and the fire is dying out slowly. I'm going to let it cool off and take all the ashes out and put it down in the bag and going home. The temperature has risen to 11 degrees, and that's not much, but it's of course because I have no front in my shelter. And my plan is to buy some kind of transparent tarp that I can put up and make a super shelter in here when I'm out here, especially during the winter and an overnighter. Then I can use that, and I'm sure the temperature will be very high in here. So that's my next project, finding a type of plastic shelter, transparent, so I can look out and that way see if anyone is coming and keep an eye on my fire pit out here. Yeah. Well, it's been a nice experience to light up this stove. It's really awesome. I love it. And I'm looking forward to using it in real life when I'm making a one-nighter here. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that before Christmas. We'll see, depending on the weather and so on, but I'm very excited to do that, so I hope I can get time for that. Yeah. And I bought such one from IKEA that I can take all the ashes out. As you can see, that's a lot of coals in here, but because I have to be home for a certain time, so I have to take this out now and let it cool off, or else this one will be hot for a very long time. And that's actually a good thing, yeah? But for now, I'm trying to be finished so I can cool this down, pack it and go home. Almost, let me see if I can show you. Yeah, you can see now it's almost empty, so the stove can cool off now and I can bring it back home. Well, that's amazing. After only 15 minutes it is completely cooled down. The glass is a little bit warm, but nothing I can't touch with. So really fast to get a temperature where I can handle it. That's good too. Very awesome. And I made a new kuxa, as you can see, from birch here out in my forest, and I think it's looking very nice. But that's not what I'm going to talk about. One of my subscribers have asked me, how do I make kuxa without it is beginning to crack? And I also have problems with that sometimes. For a while ago, I made this. It's not a kuxa, but something I can eat from. And one of the things, I don't know if you can see it, but here, it is cracked here. It doesn't matter because it doesn't go on the inside, so, and I won't have hot water in this. But as you can see, there's a crack there. And many of my kuxas has some kind of crack in that area. So I thought, why this problem? And I tried different things, and this one I made without an axe, because I think every time I cut my wood with an axe, it's a lot of stress in this area. So perhaps I'm doing it wrong, I don't know, but anyhow, then I made this only with knives, and of course something I could hollow it out, a spoon, a knife, and this one is not cracking, so perhaps that's one of the reasons, I don't know, but I'm very pleased that I got one again without cracks in, and this one is beautiful too. Now I'm going to drink it with my chaga coffee that you saw I put on the stove. It has to boil for half an hour, so it's a long time to wait, but I tried this back home with hot water in, boiling water, and it didn't crack, so I don't think that will happen now. It's also always a great pleasure to drink from something you have made yourself. I can see that it is beginning to dry a little bit. I used some mineral oil and some wax, and well, I think it's now when I'm out and it's cold and so on, it's beginning to to appear a little bit dry, so I have to do it again when I come home, but no problem there. So now I just have to wait 15 minutes, and then I can pour out my chaga coffee in this one. This I bought at the Viking market this summer, and now I made this for it and for a candle. So it's very nice. I can move it up and down, but I think this position will be nice. Not too high, perhaps there. Yeah, isn't it cool? I love it. Now it's time for my chaga coffee. Yeah, and also put whiskey in my chaga coffee. Skål. It's nice. So now it's finished. I think it is called a hanger with three, so I can put stuff on this. Primarily my clothes when I'm making a one-nighter here. I can hang my jackets and so on. Now I'm going to mount it on top, above my bed, where I sleep with my head. So. Well, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video and my shelter building series. Today it's been a okay day. Actually, I found something I found out of something very cool, because the wind is from the east, and normally it's not nice to be out here because it's blowing down in my camp, but with this shelter I don't feel the wind when I'm sitting in here, so it's really cool and nice to be here. Very cozy. As you can see, it's starting to get dark, and I'm going home and edit my video and launch it sometime this weekend. Thank you again for watching Kimmel Bushcraft, and welcome to all the new subscribers I've got. And I turned the 30,000. It's amazing. I can't believe it. Thank for all your support and your kindness. I really appreciate that. So, hope you're having a nice weekend, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.